Surrounded by a foe with 7 wins in its last 10 games, the East Wake High baseball squad knew it was in the middle of a serious squabble. The visiting Pittsburgh Northwood Chargers were certainly a cohesive unit. But then, the Warriors believe in miracles. They put their faith in performing a miracle. And the senior slinger almost perfectly provided that moray of hope. Although a leadoff Northwood double created a crack of doubt. A sacrifice bunt moved the Charger to third, where a sacrifice fly raced home the very first guy Jake Murray faced. Despite 2 more base runners by bobble and single, that was that. Jake Murray fired a strikeout to join his reinforcements in the dugout. East Wake's bat debut featured a one-out safe smash by Colby Creech. Creech crushed a 2-for-2, 2-run effort in the number 2 slot. He promptly stampeded station to station. First to second by wild pitch. Secondly to third via a Murray advance. Thirdly, all the way to the plate after Cole Alphen's clutch 2-out clip. The catcher came back to plenty of appreciation. Josh Powell pounded a double to keep the rally raucous. Yet Northwood notched a big escape K. It stayed 1-1. The Chargers chalked up an E for a 1-out threat. However, Murray fielded a hack from the heel and nailed the lead dasher at the hot corner. That humongous guess get was matched when Alphen threw out this stealer by connecting to a Devin Worley tag. In the third, an interior single posed a problem. One which shortstop Blake Boyette solved by sinking 2. East Wake offensively erupted. Colby Creech gave the Rawhide a ride as far as the fence. Then more Jake Murray motored down the middle of Broadway, setting up Cole Alphen for the Here the Hero Go again. Harrison Neese added to the advantage, issuing a distant fly and speeding Murray across. That 3-1 edge survived every ensuing enemy challenge. Of course, Jake Murray played his part in the drama department. He fell behind 3-0 to this Charger slugger, then smoked him on 3 straight strikes. Devin Worley easily apprehended an exit. Then lefty on lefty left this Northwood lumberjack hexed. Extra breathing room, though, was smothered by this close call at first. after Blake Boyette walked and accelerated to bait the adversary, he ended up wrongly erased by a late glove tap. The promising blastoff thus imploded. Warrior Darius Welcome hospitably hailed a center pop. Then Josh Powell absolutely robbed a shallow shot to right. Earning an acrobatic accolade. When Jake Murray grabbed his chopper, the big dancers were now turning the diamond into a mosh pit. However, East Wake could not reach that next stage fast enough. An opening single in the Northwood Six was followed by Murray Fanning. The Chargers kept looking for a bright spot, while Coach Tony Piercy's pack kept dealing with tight spots. Murray's lone base on balls all night put two on with a long gone. So he wound up and whipped by the dangerous DH again. Worthy then dipped and delivered the crucial surge derailing, nailing. Blake Boyette snapped a string of 9 East Wake retirees in a row using this left field lick. Then he snatched scoring position, only to be stranded there. Murray mustered a strong take it or break it 7th inning. By blow by, bye bye. Northwood resisted a quick fade. Not even after Murray mowed down the next Charger. Reaching his regulated pitch count, Murray exited on the cusp of a complete conquer. Reliever Harrison Neese, please. He allowed a walk to ratchet the tension, then saved the day, coercing a simple arc to who else? Murray now filling in at first. Jake Murray finished what he started after all. And the boss backed up his club's courageous campaign.
Bring a hat. And you're going to be one of about 2 or 3, maybe 4 teams that are still there tomorrow that still play. So ain't no need to tell everybody that. They know. All right? They know.
I knew that my pitch count was getting up there and before the end, and I knew I had 12 pitches. And the second to last batter, he worked me about, I think it was 9 or 8 pitches. And I was just trying to get him out so I could get to that last batter and have a chance of ending the game right there. Ball was a little shady tonight. Left my changeup up a lot, which cost me a few hits there. But I was really commanding my fastball on the lower outside part of the plate.
Well, this squad is a lot of people. We thought we had a chip on our shoulder at the beginning of the year because a lot of people around the school said we lost 8-9 seniors last year and all of our pitching from last year, and they said we weren't going to be worth the darn and we weren't going to make the playoffs and this, that, and the other. And these guys kind of took that personal and kind of used that as a little bit of fuel to, hey, you can tell me I can't do something. And they kind of trying to prove people wrong. So right. They did a good job of molding together. And one thing they have done a really good job of is learning from mistakes in previous games and not duplicating those later on. So I'm very proud of this group.
This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.